Assalamu alaikum class, I am Dr. Masuma. Today I am going to teach you the practical, that is demonstration of superficial, visceral and deep reflexes. Before starting the practical, you should know about reflex. What is reflex? It is an involuntary automatic response of an effector to an appropriate stimuli without the intervention of will. So, what is reflex? That is, it is an involuntary and automatic response. That is, in it our will is not included. It is an involuntary automatic response of an effector to an appropriate stimuli without the intervention of will. It depends upon the integrity of reflex arc. When we give stimulus to the skin, or when there is a stimulus to the skin, mucous membrane or muscle tendon, impulses go from there to the level of spinal cord or cranial nerve nuclei. From there, the impulses come back to the skin tissue or muscles. So, the skin, mucous membrane or tendon act as a receptors. Perceive impulses, afferents go from there to the level of spinal cord or cranial nerve nuclei, which act as an integrating center. From there, impulses come back to the skin tissue or muscles and they perform function. So they act as an effectors. So the receptors, afferents, integrating center, efferents, and effectors, they make an arc that is called as reflex arc. And the reflex that is shown, it depends upon the integrity of this reflex arc. In order to understand the reflexes, we classify the reflexes on the basis of number of synapses and on the basis of clinical findings. On the basis of number of synapses, the synapses are classified as monosynaptic reflex and polysynaptic reflex. What do you mean by monosynaptic reflex? It means it is such a synapse which is involving one synapse between the afferent and efferent neurons. It means there is only one synapse. Or a reflex arc consists of only one sensory neuron or one motor neuron, or there is formation of only one synapse between afferent and efferent neurons. And the example of monosynaptic reflexes like patellar reflex, Achilles reflex and etc. Then polysynaptic reflex. Poly mean multiple, many. In this synapse, two or more synapses are formed between afferent or efferent neurons, like superficial reflexes or visceral reflexes. Clinically, we classify the reflexes as superficial reflexes, deep reflexes, visceral reflexes or pathological reflexes. Superficial reflexes are elicited by stimulation of the skin or mucous membrane, like plantar reflex, abdominal reflex, corneal or conjunctival reflex. Deep reflexes are elicited due to stimulation of the receptors present in the muscle fiber or tendons, like knee jerk, bicep jerk or tricep. Visceral reflexes are like pupillary reflex, oculocardic reflex, and pathological reflexes like Babinski's sign. We will discuss these reflexes one by one. Superficial reflexes. First of all, in superficial reflexes, they are elicited by stimulating the skin and mucous membrane. They are polysynaptic, and they are dependent on the integrity of the corticospinal tracts. Then visceral reflexes, they are elicited by the stimulation of the deep viscera. The examples are of visceral reflexes are like pupillary reflexes, oculocardic reflexes and carotid reflexes. And usually we perform the pupillary reflexes. Principle. When a sense organ is stimulated, impulse is transmitted through afferent nerve to the center, then back to the effector through efferent nerve to produce response. So, what is the protocol of the practical? Always introduce yourself to the subject, explain the procedure, take consent, properly expose the part of the body that is to be examined, and always perform and compare the reflexes on right and left side. Okay? Then comes the apparatus that we require. One is the examination couch. Apparatus that is required for this practical is the examination couch. Blunt object such as keys, wisp of cotton, torch, tongue depressor, sterilized or clinical hammer. Now we start our, we create the reflexes for the clinical examination. There are four grades. Grade 0, when there is no reflex or there is the reflex is absent. Grade 1, when the reflex is present as a normal ankle jerk. Grade 2, when the reflex is brisk as a normal knee jerk. Grade 3, very brisk response. And in the grade 4, clonus, that is increased reflex activity by repetitive muscular contractions. Gendrasix maneuver. This is very important maneuver and helpful in the elicitation of the reflexes. For reflexes of the upper limb, we ask the subject to clench his teeth, and for lower limb reflexes, we ask the subject to interlock the flexed fingers. How it is helpful? There is reinforcement increases the excitability of the anterior horn cells by increasing the sensory discharge. Second, gendrasic maneuver is helpful as the subject attention is diverted. And third, do not declare a reflex to be absent before eliciting it with reinforcement. Now, I will show you how to do the gendrasic maneuver. आमिर साहब, हमने आपका थोड़ा सा एग्जाम चेकअप और करना है, क्या आप इसकी इजाज़त देते हैं?
जी।
इसमें हम इस तरह करेंगे कि आपने अपने दांतों को जोर से जो है उनको पीसना है, ठीक है? जी, इस तरह, ये देखें, दिस इज क्लेंचिंग ऑफ द टीथ, जोर से क्लेंचिंग ऑफ द टीथ, एंड दिस इज हेल्पफुल फॉर द रिफ्लेक्सेस ऑफ द अपर लिम. अब आपने अपने हाथों की उंगलियों को इस तरह करना है कि एक हाथ की उंगलियों में दूसरे हाथ की उंगलियों को फंसाना है इस तरह, और उनको जोर लगा के आपने कोशिश करना है अलहदा करने की, लेकिन जोर लगाना है, अलहदा नहीं करना, ठीक है? ये देखें जिस तरह मैं कर रही हूँ, एक हाथ की उंगलियों में दूसरे हाथ की उंगलियों को, एक हाथ की उंगलियों में दूसरे हाथ की उंगलियों को आपने लेके और इनको एक दूसरे की तरफ खींचना है, ठीक है? एक हाथ पहले इस तरह करें,
अब दूसरे हाथ की उंगलियों को इसके अंदर फंसाएं और इनको खींचें, ठीक है। ये देखें स्टूडेंट्स, बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया। इसमें आपने देखा कि इस तरह दोबारा कर लें, दोबारा एक दफ़ा करें, इसको पहले इस तरह करें जी। अब इस दूसरे हाथ की उंगलियों को इसमें फंसाएं और ज़ोर लगा के खींचने की कोशिश करें। ये देखें इन्होंने इंटरलॉक की है दोनों फिंगर्स को और उनके जो है ऐसी हो गए हैं हाथ के मसल्स के यू कैन द रिफ्लेक्सेस कैन बी बेस्ट एलिसिटेड और सब्जेक्ट की अटेंशन भी डाइवर्ट हो जाती है। ओके थैंक यू। ओके क्लास, व्हेनेवर वी आर चेकिंग द रिफ्लेक्स वी शुड कंसिडर सम पॉइंट्स। व्हाट आर दीज? वी शुड नो द रिफ्लेक्स, दैट इज वी आर गोइंग टू एग्जामिन। व्हाट इज द लेवल ऑफ स्पाइनल कॉर्ड, हाउ टू इलिसिट द रिफ्लेक्स एंड व्हाट इज द नॉर्मल रिस्पॉन्स ऑफ दैट रिफ्लेक्स। वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद द प्लांटर रिफ्लेक्स। The level of spinal cord for the plantar reflex is S1 and S2. Now we will perform the practical. We should follow the protocol. What is this? That is, we should take consent. We should introduce ourselves to the subject. We should take consent and explain the procedure to the subject. Properly expose the part that is to be examined and comparison of the reflexes on both sides. Assalamu alaikum. मेरा नाम डॉक्टर मासूमा है। मैंने आपके ऊपर कुछ एग्जामिनेशन करना है, चेक करना है आपके पैर के ऊपर जो है वो टेस्ट करना है कि आप इसकी इजाज़त देते हैं
जी।
ओके प्लीज गिविंग अस द कंसेंट। Now, what is the procedure of the plantar reflex? We will scratch the outer edge of his foot from the heel towards the little toe and then medially across the metatarsal with the blunt object such as key. You can see that there is dorsiflexed, that is the normal response, that is greater toe goes downward and there is flexion and adduction of the all other toes. So he has normal plantar reflex and that is also called as Bibinski's negative. We compare it on the other side, the same procedure, that is we scratch the outer edge of his foot starting from the heel towards the little toes and then medially across the metatarsal towards the great toe. So you can see there is dorsiflexion or there is dorsiflexion of the big toe. The big toes move downwards and the little toes are flexed and adducted. So he has the normal plantar reflex on both foot, or this is also called as Bibinski's negative. Okay, we have done plantar reflex. Level of spinal cord for the plantar reflex is S1 and S2. You have seen how we have performed the plantar reflex. And what is the normal response for the plantar reflex? That is, foot is dorsiflexed, greater toes goes downwards, there is flexion and adduction of all other toes. This is the normal response. And it is also called as Bibinski's negative. There is a term that is Bibinski's positive. It is a very common question that is asked in the examination, in the vivas, in the practical. What is Bibinski's negative and what is Bibinski's positive? The normal response of the plantar reflex is Bibinski's negative. Okay students, the normal response of the plantar reflex is Bibinski's negative. And what is Bibinski's positive? There will be plantar flexion of the foot, greater toes will go upward, and there will be extension and abduction of all other toes. These are the signs of the positive Bibinski's. When this positive Babinkis comes, it can be seen in the upper motor neuron lesion in the infants below 1 year of age. Why it is seen in the infants below 1 year of age normally? Because in the infants below 1 year of age, the myelination of the pyramidal cracks occur through this year, through this time. So normally in the infants below 1 year of age, Babinkis will be positive. During deep sleep, normally Babinkis is positive and inhibition of pyramidal crack. So positive Babinkis is an abnormal reflex, but physiologically it is present in the infants below 1 year of age and during deep sleep and inhibition of the pyramidal crack. Next is the abdominal reflex. Level of spinal cord for the abdominal reflex is from T7 to T12. And how it is elicited? Patient should be in the supine position. Abdomen should be properly uncovered. Muscles should be relaxed. And we make a gentle stroke with a blunt object parallel to the costal margin or inguinal ligament. And what is the normal response? That is, a ripple of contraction of abdominal muscles comes. Another superficial reflex is the scapular reflex, and level of spinal cord for this is C5 to T1, and we strike or scratch the skin in the interscapular region, and what happens, what comes, there is contraction of the supra or infraspinatus muscle. Another superficial reflex is the anal reflex. Level of spinal cord is S3 and S4. We scratch the skin near the anus, and what is the normal response? There is contraction of anal sphincter. Then is the cremasteric reflex. Level of spinal cord is L1 and L2. Stroke the skin on upper and lower part of the thigh, and there will be contraction of the cremasteric muscle around testes. Now comes the visceral reflexes. Visceral reflexes are of following types, like pupillary reflex, you students have already done. Oculocardial reflex. In this reflex, pressure on the eyeball is applied with closed eyes. It produces the slowing of the heart rate. This is usually routinely not performed. Then carotid or splinter reflex. In this reflex, massage on the carotid sinus causes slowing of the heart rate. So, we usually perform the corneal reflex, conjunctival reflex or pupillary reflexes. Today, we will perform the corneal reflex and conjunctival reflex. For the corneal reflex, afferent is 5th cranial nerve, ophthalmic division of the trigeminal nerve. And the efferent is 7th cranial nerve. For the conjunctival reflex, efferent is ophthalmic division of the trigeminal nerve and the efferent is 7th cranial nerve. In the corneal reflex, what we do? We ask the subject to look at the ceiling and twist. We take a light wisp of cotton and touch the lateral edge of the cornea at the corneoscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleroscleros we will repeat the procedure on the other eye to compare it. In the case of conjunctival reflex, we ask the subject to look at the ceiling and we take a little wisp of cotton and touch the lateral margin of the sclera. There is bilateral blinking of the eyelids and the two sides should be compared. ओके आमिर साहब, हम आपकी आंखों का मुआयना करने लगे हैं. इसमें ये है कि हम एक ये कॉटन के ज़रिए आपकी आंखों का मुआयना करेंगे. ये थोड़ा सा आपकी आंखों में टच होगी तो फिर हमने देखना है कि उसका इसके टच करने से क्या नज़र आता है. क्या आप ऐसा इजाज़त देते हैं?
जी.
आपने इस तरह करना है कि आपने थोड़ी देर के लिए कमरे की सीलिंग की छत की तरफ देखना है, ठीक है? और
we ask the subject to look at the ceiling and we touch at the lateral lateral margin of the cornea at the corneoscleral junction and there is bilateral blinking of the both eyes. We will repeat the procedure on the other eye. आप कमरे की छत की तरफ देखें. In conjunctival reflex, we touch the wisp of the cotton at the lateral border of the sclera on both eyes one by one and there will be bilateral blinking of both eyes. आमिर साहब आपने कमरे की छत की तरफ देखना है. Okay, you have seen that there is bilateral blinking of both eyes. We will compare it with the other eye and we will try to touch the lateral margin of the sclera. There is bilateral blinking of both eyes. Thank you very much, Amir sir. Students, you have seen that patient subject has got normal corneal and conjunctival reflex. There is bilateral blinking of both eyes on corneal and conjunctival examination. Aapka bahut